Hello, I'm Ed Delgado. I'm the National Predictive Services Program Manager at NPSI in Boise, Idaho. Fire season is progressing as it normally would from the southwest to the northwestern parts of the United States, but we're not seeing the activity that we typically see this time of year. Cool conditions that we had in the spring and the early fire season start that we had earlier this year has all sort of moderated, and we are seeing fire activity, but not as much as we typically would see this time of year. Recent rains across the southwestern United States have put a damper on a lot of fire activity there, and fuel conditions in the interior of the West have not evolved as quickly as they did last year when we were well into fire season by now. So looking ahead at July, we still expect to see some lingering fire in the southwestern states, New Mexico and Arizona, but with the onset of the monsoon in the next week or two, we should see that activity come to a quick end. Although we do expect the monsoon to not be as strong as it usually is, and there may be periods of drying where we could see an increase in fire activity for short periods across the Southwest. Meanwhile, the western parts of the Great Basin, Nevada, southeastern Oregon, and southwestern Idaho, remain pretty dry and will be receptive to fire as we get the right conditions to ignite fires and to sustain them with winds and dry conditions. California has been under the gun most of the summer, most of the spring, and will continue to see occasional fires in that area. We haven't seen a lot of fires because we haven't seen the lightning activity, but as we head into the hotter months and into the peak season for California, that could change as well. We also have some dryness across parts of the high plains in western Montana and into the Dakotas, where dry grasses have grown to levels that we haven't seen in recent years, and windy dry conditions could dry fire there. Heading into August, we expect the conditions to remain across California and the western parts of the Great Basin and even into some of the High Plains region. But as we start getting into September, October, which we typically see fire season come to an end, and in conditions will start to decrease across the Great Basin and even parts of the Northwest and the Northern Rockies. But California will remain active as they start entering their peak wind season.